Hi there guys, it's Rick Graham here and I'm bringing you another column for Guitar Interactive magazine. Today we're going to start a new series of columns and I want to focus my attention on one of the most important aspects of being a guitar player. Well, it certainly is for me anyway. And I'm going to talk about phrasing and articulation and all of the elements that I feel are important to build upon that particular skill set. There's a lot involved with phrasing and articulation, so I'm going to be covering a lot of topics. So make sure you stay tuned for the forthcoming columns. To start with though, I'm going to talk about one of the most overlooked techniques among guitar players. I think it's extremely overlooked, but I also think it's one of the most important techniques to acquire, and that is vibrato technique. So vibrato, there's lots of different ways that you can approach it. I'm very much kind of into feeling your way through vibrato. You know, it's really, really important to just feel how it works, you know, with the left hand, and kind of get into the flow that way. However, I think you can approach it from kind of a bit more of a scientific standpoint as well. So I'm going to talk a little bit about both of that and how I bring those both together. So first things first, vibrato. What exactly is it? I see vibrato as kind of pretty much the same as string bending. You're doing the same thing. You're manipulating the pitch of a note by bending the string. Just so happens with string bending, it's kind of applied in a slightly different way. With vibrato, it tends to be short, frequent oscillations of the pitch. So if I just give you a note to start with, let's take this note here. I'm taking the fifth note of the G string. In this case, it's a C note. Okay, so I'm just going to play the vibrato here and then I'll explain how I approach it and how I practice it. Okay, so here's our note. Okay, so that's how I would apply vibrato. First things first, notice how even the vibrato is. When I actually bend the string, it always goes back to the same pitch. Okay, so when I'm bending the string up, it always returns to exactly the same pitch. Okay, so let me just do that again. And also, how I separate the oscillations of that pitch are also even. Okay, so I like to see vibrato almost like a line, you know, say the pitch that we have, the original pitch, let's call it, is this. So that can be seen as a line, but the oscillation of the pitch allows us to oscillate that pitch at regular intervals so that we bring it up and then release the bend back to the original pitch. Okay, so we're getting a regular oscillation of this pitch, if you see what I mean. One of the most important things about this is that you control that element of it, okay? So that's what we're going to do. We're just going to start with this note here. The other thing is, for good vibrato, I tend to find that I like to put my thumb higher over the neck, so you might want to sort of mess around with your left-hand position for this. If it's too low on the fret, too low on the back of the neck, it's not as comfortable doing vibrato. Not saying you can't, you know, it's not possible to do it, but this is the way that I like to do it. It just gives a bit more control. So all you need to do to practice vibrato is just bend the string. And what we're going to do, we're going to bend it slightly sharp, okay? Okay, and that's how I practice it. But notice every single oscillation is at a regular interval and the pitch is exactly the same. So those two elements have got to be in place. A lot of the time when you hear vibrato that isn't very well controlled, those change the frequency of the oscillation and the pitch. So you'll hear this kind of thing, which is kind of awful. So it's best to avoid that and try and approach it in this fashion. So, All we're doing is bending that string at regular intervals, going to the same exact pitch. Now at this point, it doesn't really sound like vibrato. But the idea is while you're doing that, you're getting the feel for it. You know, that's really, really important to find that feel with the left hand. So then all we need to do is to speed it up slightly. Okay, now it's getting a bit more recognizable as vibrato. And then you just gradually speed it up so it becomes more natural. Okay, does that make sense? So that's how I like to approach practicing vibrato. Lots of different ways that you can approach it, you know, on different strings. You can apply this to an already bent string, which is, it's actually, that's a bit more of a specialized technique that we'll look at later on down the line. But for now, you know, it's really, really important to concentrate on this if you want a good solid vibrato. Vibrato is something which allows you to create your own voice on the instrument. It's a very, very unique thing to guitar players. And you'll listen to certain different players that have completely different vibrato. You know, like somebody like Angus Young has a very, very aggressive, fast-sounding vibrato. Sounds nice and controlled, but against somebody like Eric Clapton, who has a completely different sounding vibrato. You know, but each one of those, they have a unique voice with it. So as a guitar player, I think it's really, really important to concentrate on this and practice this just as you practice everything else. So it's essential. So just going back to that, what you can do, what I like to do is practice changing the pitch. So a more subtle vibrato means that if you want to achieve a more subtle vibrato, what I do is only vary the pitch slightly, just fractionally. Can you hear? I'm not really bending the string. It's not even a semitone, it's less than that. But if I want a bit more of an aggressive vibrato, you know, I'll bend the pitch higher. Can you hear there? I'm kind of going a little bit in between a semitone and a whole tone. That's more of a whole tone, but if you can hear that the more you bend the string, the more kind of aggressive it can sound. So you can manipulate these to your own ends when it comes to improvising, you know. If you've got a long soaring melody line, you perhaps want to control the vibrato and not bend the string as much. You know, if you've got something that's a bit more, you know, aggressive and needs that kind of sound, then you might want to think about bending the string a little bit more. So vibrato can be approached in this way. It's important to do this on different strings as well, because it's going to... It takes a different kind of technique, especially when you're doing it on the higher strings. Like the D string, what I usually do is actually oscillate the pitch in the opposite direction, purely because I don't want to slip off the edge of the fretboard here. So let's say we're here at fret 10 of the B string. You know, I'll practice bending upwards instead. The other thing that, a little tip, insider tip that I'll give you here is when you're when I'm bending vibrato on upper strings, what I'll usually do is with right hand fingers, I'll just hold the upper strings. And in some instances, what I'll do, say if I'm on the B string, I'll pull this E string up. And what that does, that allows me to kind of, if I'm doing it in this direction, that allows me to bounce the finger off the adjacent string, the higher string. It feels comfortable to do. Not only that, it helps from a muting perspective. So, because when you do this, sometimes you can get, you know, adjacent strings ringing off, and you don't want that. So what I'll do is I'll rest the fingers on the upper strings, and usually the pick on or thumb across the lower strings. That way, it's clean as a whistle. So I just wanted to talk to you about that particular technique. It's one of the most, in my opinion, one of the most important techniques that a guitar player can have at his disposal. And as I say before, it really, really helps you to find your own voice on the instrument. And, you know, for the developing musician, I feel that's extremely important. Why would you want to sound like somebody else? You want to sound like you. So this is a way that you can really, really develop that. So work on changing you know, how quickly you oscillate the pitch, you know, the frequency of the oscillation, and also how much you bend the string as well. So once you get a grasp of that, you can really start to get control of your vibrato technique. So that's how I approach it. Try it and see how you get on with it. Okay, that wraps up today's lesson. I really hope you've enjoyed this lesson. I've got loads of stuff lined up for you regarding phrasing and articulation, so we're going to continue that in the next column. But in the meantime, practice hard. Thanks a lot, guys. Speak soon. Hi there, guys. It's Rick here, back again for another column for Guitar Interactive magazine. Today, we're going to continue the sweep picking series. And what I'd like to concentrate on today is inside picking.